All right. Today's Friday, and there weren't really any sales today, right? Like one crummy one.
Yeah,
just what's the point?
I wasn't interested.
So what we're gonna do is I'm just gonna go to the showcase, and I should be picking up a couple of checks, and I'm just gonna neaten it up and put some stuff in there. I have a feeling I might have sold all of the models, the car models I put in last time, but I'm not sure. I'm gonna find out on that. If I did, that'd be great, because that took up a lot of room. I'm hoping this isn't the last time we go to the showcase before I take my vacation, but it might be, I don't know. So this might be the end of the year in the showcase. I see how I did, like if I actually came out ahead, right, and or made any money. I think I made some money, but we'll see. And that's basically what I'm gonna do now. Just gonna check the showcase, put a little stuff in. I don't think I'll take any stuff out, and just see what's happening. All right, that's today for us, and then we're gonna run some errands, right? All right, anyway. To the Batmobile? To the showcase. All right. Yeah, we're on our way. I know I didn't take that. All right. Here I am. This is my showcase. I'm just showing what's here. Compare it to whatever video came before this. Actually, I'm just going to go across and come back. I'll keep it like in one steady flowing motion. This is like a lava plate we sold, right? Okay. These are nice. I don't expect them to be gone, but...
You must have sold some glasses.
Yes, I definitely. That's why I've been bringing in more glasses.
Did you sell a precious moment?
That's possible. I think I did, you know? Something... Like, did I sell the one that was on top of the box? Like, they didn't want the box? All right, well, let me just keep flow... I'll keep the flow going. I'll just show it's here. You know, sometimes it's hard to see. Like, I don't know if I'm selling any... I didn't sell any game stuff, I don't think. That should be a good deal, you know? Should have sold this. I don't know if I had something back there. The one thing, like we said, I think I sold something here, precious ones. I know I sold some glasses. They're not high ticket items. I didn't sell any of these bowls. I don't know if I had anything there, but I'm gonna add to that area. Probably the cloisonné vases I got. This stuff I don't necessarily expect to sell, but whatever. It looks like I sold something back there. You know, I've only been coming like once a month, so I am not really paying attention to this as much as I should be. Here's the big disappointment. Someone actually called and wanted to know what I would do if they bought all of these, so I said 15 bucks a piece, and they passed, so I'm gonna let them sit here, you know? And I don't care how long they take to sell, and if I have to, I'll put them on eBay, you know? Maybe I'll save them for the future, whatever I'm going to do. Did you tell them about the other thing or no?
What are the things?
Oh, okay. Anyway, that's what I have here. And now I'm going to put some stuff in. All right, so this is what I'm going to be putting in the store. Showcase, actually. This stuff isn't really good for the store, the way the store is set up right now, because it's more decorative stuff. That's why I like having the showcase and keeping them separate. Decorative stuff at the store sells a little bit here or there, but the store is more like toys and games right now, like a lot of games, a lot of toys. And this stuff is fragile, and we, to be honest, we don't get enough traffic that would support putting decorative stuff out. That's not specific to what the people want. I do put some in there, just because I like decorative stuff. It's the way I am. But anyway, this is all going to showcase, and I'll just show you what I'm putting in. I didn't get a chance to put a lot, but I picked this stuff anyway. I got a green, really nice, signed on the bottom, Costa Boda Bowl. I feel 25 bucks is a really good price on that. Somebody ought to scoop that up, especially with such a nice green Christmassy color. Here's a Fenton Silvercrest painted bowl, put it 20 bucks. That should be a good price. And it's, to me, it's very Christmassy again. It's almost snowflake-like, you know? This is cool, but again, I wouldn't put this in the shop. I don't think it would get enough attention there. I believe this mall has more foot traffic, and the kind of foot traffic that buys this stuff than our shop does at this point. But anyway, this is a George Briard enamel cookie jar. Pretty cool. I like the fruit design. These are fun, but these would get lost in the store again. In a showcase, I can put them right at eye level. Somebody will notice, and they won't be easily knocked over. And they're basically Baby Stewie shot glasses. Put $10 on it, too. Had a pair of these really nice cloisonné vases. Unfortunately, one of the vases is as-is. Is it majorly as-is? Nah. It has that dent. So, what I decided was I'm going to price it at about the price of one vase. And what would be considered, in my opinion, a good price for just one vase. Because, here, I'll show these. I'll show on the bottom. These definitely have age. Just focus in on that. That says China on the bottom. Oh, and plus I also have the wood bases. But having China on the bottom would date these to, I don't know, early 1900s. Okay, and the last few things I'm going to put in the shoe case are these glasses. I have 7 glasses like these. And then I have this one that's different. This one's a Yankees glass. It's got Yankees on the front and the bottom. The reason I price the glasses separately is because not everybody wants 6 or 7 glasses. Some people just need one glass for their collection. And then if they want to buy all of them, they can always contact me and ask for some discount or a better price on the grouping. Anyway, that's what's going in. Let's see if I fit it or how I fit it.
Hold on a second. All right. So I don't think I did anything to this shelf. So this is pretty much the same. On this shelf, for the big George Briard cookie jar. And then I moved. Oh, is this okay over here?
Yeah.
Okay, that's good enough. You don't want to like shift stuff around a little bit, like move this, like it's like maybe move this a little bit over, then spread those out a little bit, just to give this a little more space. Like move that a little bit more over closer. Okay. Wait, Marie's gonna do that.
You gotta push stuff back.
I thought I had it far.
Well, yeah, that's just talking about the fence and edges. That one I thought I had all the way to the back. Okay, almost all the way.
All right. So anyway, that's the shelf. Let me just
walk in front of you, and then I'll be out of your way for a minute.
All right, so that's this shelf. I just moved these from here to here. I don't want to do nothing with this shelf. This can sit here for now. I don't really care. I can take this stuff to anywhere if I want to.
So when that sells, it's the same for this. This I can sell. I can literally sell this anytime I want, but I want it to be here for now, you know? So this, pretty much the same. I don't think I changed anything here. Okay. On this shelf, this stuff was somewhere else, so now it's here, and I'm trying to keep most of the Asian together. I put those cloisonné vases in there. I let people know that it's not perfect. There's the Costa Boda bowl. This shelf, I think I changed the most out of everything. Fit all the glasses here. And then just shifted the kind of Aztec-y and other stuff around. So it's like, you know, so it's there. Then on this shelf, I have 4 Fenton bowls. So I was like, keep all the Fenton bowls together. I have one large and 2 that are pink and one has the coin dot. Still leaving those Pokemon things in there. Those, again, I could put them online anytime I want. I just don't have to yet. There's a Wallace Nutting. Okay, let's see what I did over here. This, I don't think I changed much at all. I really don't think I changed anything. So that's pretty much the same. Yes, let me turn this a little bit. Just there. Is that a little better? Okay, then bottom, I don't think I touched. Did not move a single thing. Let's see if it's it. No, and I didn't do anything here. And like I said, I did have someone who called and was like, what can you do for all of them? I don't know how thought it was going to go if he has to think about it. But to me, it doesn't matter. Those can sell. Just be patient. And then this finishes it out pretty much the same. We did it. We were there. Not much was gone. And I was disappointed about the model kits being gone. But that guy basically wanted to pay $9 a piece. And I'm in too much to do that. So it's not worth it for me. On the model kits. This year, out of that place, I think I'll probably would have done a little better than break even, something like that. So that's the story with that. That's how my year went there. I have one more shot to make some money there.
So if I do have a good December, I don't know. I mean, it's hard to tell. But I don't know. That place is more for me, hopefully a place to make some money and kind of a storage for stuff that I want to take to different markets and stuff that I want to know where it is. Stuff that might wind up on eBay or to antique-y places, like antique markets, when I get a chance, like Rutherford. Last time I did Rutherford, I went in, I raided it. It's like a weird thing. When you have a lot of stuff, stuff starts to get buried. You know what I mean, right, Marie? You just... Well, stuff does start to get buried, and you just don't know where stuff is winding up. Anyway, we were there. I did what I did, and now I'm going to get some lunch. So, goodbye.